Since his confrontations with 257 and Mr. B, Delatripp had remained completely silent in the presence of the other engines, who were still rather cross with him due to his attitude on his first day on the line. He was painfully aware that Mr. B appeared to be watching him wherever he went, and so refrained from making any comments at all, just in case Mr. B happened to reveal his secret. Mr. Dark was happy with his performance, however, and decided to keep him on, despite initial complaints from the rest of the fleet. Meanwhile, over in the museum, Turbo had been enjoying his rest, talking to visitors, speaking to the other museum engines, and generally feeling much more rested than he had done for a long time. Though the other engine complained about their situations from time to time, Turbo was quite satisfied with his experience so far, and was secretly quite glad that he was at the back of the overhaul queue for the time being. One warm morning, Turbo was awoken when he heard movement nearby. He saw that Dave, Ed and Sid had all been taken outside, and that Buzz was heading towards him.
Hello, Turbo.
Hi, Buzz. What's going on with the engines? Why are they outside?
Haven't you heard? The works finally has some more room to commence overhauls. So Dave, Ed and Sid are moving into the works.
And Otto too?
No, Otto's just being moved to a different road, as are you.
Is that so you can move Eddie into the works too?
Eddie? The collared goods behind you? No, he's remaining where he is for the time being. Mr. Dark says he wants to rotate the fleet a little, and Eddie isn't needed at the moment.
Oh, okay. That's not good.
Yeah, it's a bit of a shame. But the museum still needs some exhibits. And Mr. Dark still needs to decide which other engines will be withdrawn for display over the next few months. So for the time being, you're moving over nearer to Otto.
Fair enough. Eddie had heard these exchanges from the back of the museum, and felt rather upset. To see that his friends were all going in for overhaul, and that his nearest companion was being moved further away from him, made him worry a little. Looks like they're all abandoning us, huh? Yeah, we're on our own. I told you this would happen. Everyone forgot about me pretty quickly. Now they're forgetting about you too. I haven't forgotten about you. Exactly, that's why I'm still here. To keep you company whilst everyone else moves on and forgets. I'm sure that isn't the case. Oh, but it is. Can't you see? Dave, Ed and Sid are being overhauled. Turbo's moving away to be closer to Otto. It's just you back here all alone. Forgotten. Discarded. I mean, who knows? Perhaps the others aren't really being overhauled. Perhaps they're going to be scrapped. Just like me. Don't be ridiculous. You're just making things up. I can assure you I'm not making things up. Besides, if I'm making things up, then why would it matter? I'm made up anyway. That's not the point. It kind of is. I'm only here because you can't accept the fact that I'm not really here anymore. Face the facts, Eddie. Nobody gives a toss about us anymore. Everybody's abandoning you. No one cares about you. And there's nothing you can do about it. Shut up! Just shut up and leave me alone! Go away!
Who is he talking to?
I don't know. Eddie? Are you alright? Huh? Yeah, I'm fine. Oh, okay then. You ready then, Buzz?
Yeah, sure.
Oh, for fuck's sake.
257 Squadron had not had a chance to try and talk to Delatripp for a few weeks now. He had been requested for a handful of mainline rail tours, along with Eustace and Caracas, and so could be absent from the railway for several days at a time. Whenever he did return to the line, Delatripp would be nowhere to be seen, and when 257 did see him, the N-15 would make himself scarce quite quickly. He began to get quite downhearted about all this, and spoke to the other engines. I've been trying to catch him so I can try and explain myself better, but he doesn't want to know. I don't know why you're trying so hard, 257. If he clearly doesn't care, why are you bothering? Because he's still my friend at the end of the day. We knew each other for so long. I'd hate to throw everything away over a slight misrepresentation of the truth.
You mean a lie?
I wouldn't call it a lie, per se. You can't base a friendship on lies, 257. I'm not sticking up for him, but if you had been honest with him in the first place, maybe things would have panned out better for you two.
I've never lied to Dave or Raymond.
Yes, you have. You told me that Calgon would make my engine sound better, and all it did was make me sound like a washing machine.
Well, that was indeed a slight misrepresentation of the truth.
Your lie broke my prime mover.
Well, this isn't the time or the place to bring this up, Raymond.
We're trying to comfort our good friend in his time of need. You didn't confront me in my time of need when you caused my engine to break. But I apologised. Isn't that enough?
Not for some engines. This guy sounds quite stubborn and self-important. I'd just let it go if I were you, 257. You have us.
I suppose so. But still,
just let him calm down and get over himself. He'll come round eventually.
But Hannah was wrong. As the summer arrived, and schedules became even busier, the engines had less and less time to socialise, and Delatrip remained silent and frosty. This was beginning to wind up 257 to no end, and eventually, he could stand it no longer. One evening, he saw that Delatrip had been disposed of for the night at Mirku, and was sleeping in the further shed room from the other engines.
Hey, Trip!
Delatrip opened his eyes, seeing 257 arriving in the vacant road next to him. With no crew, he was unable to leave the vicinity.
I want to talk. Well, I don't want to talk to you. Just leave me to be in peace.
But I can't. I can't just leave this unresolved. I know that I deceived you, and I know that I upset you, but I want to make amends. I don't want to throw our friendship away over this, mate.
How dare you? You expect my forgiveness? You want to just forget that this happened? Our entire friendship was false! You lied through your teeth for years!
You expect forgiveness, 257? Well, you're not getting it! I wish I'd never met you! I wish you'd never been built! 257 looked shocked and was on the verge of tears. The other engines looked over at the sound of Delatrip's rage voice.
You don't mean that.
I do. Every word of it. You've overstepped the mark this time, coming to me, begging for forgiveness, when you can clearly see that I have no choice but to remain and listen to your drivel. I do not tolerate charlatans, liars and deceivers.
So you mean like yourself then, Trip?
Everybody fell silent. Don't you say another word. What did you say, Mr. B?
You yourself have just overstepped the mark there, Delatrip. I told you that if you upset anyone else again, I'd tell everyone your secret.
Secret? What secret?
You lot stay out of this, especially you. You're not even a proper resident of this railway or this region.
And technically speaking, neither are you. You've been deceiving everybody since you got here. You talk about 257 deceiving you. You've been deceiving him and lying to him since you two first met.
What are you on about?
Delatrip here isn't all that he says that he is. And I've heard enough tonight.
Don't you dare!
257, where did Delatrip tell you he was built?
Well, like every other member of the class, of course. Easily!
This is an outright fabrication.
Delatrip began to panic. Mr. B, please! Don't do this!
It's too late, mate. Everybody deserves the truth. Especially 257. Doesn't he deserve the truth as well? After all these years?
What is he on about, Trip? Nothing! Just ignore him! He's... What haven't you told me? It's nothing! Honestly, it's... It isn't!
Delatrip was not, in fact, built at Eastley, like he claims to have been. Five and Clyde might be interested to learn this, but our Delatrip here...
No!
...was built at the North British Locomotive Company, in Glasgow.
Delatrip looked supremely uncomfortable as the other engine stared at him. 257, in particular, looked absolutely devastated. Is this true? Of course not! What utter...
I can assure you, 257, it's true. I was there when he was being put back together, and I saw his builder's plate, which is conveniently hidden behind his smoke deflectors at the moment. It's a North British builder's plate. I thought you knew 257.
257 didn't reply. 257? 257? 257! 257, come back! But he was stuck. He couldn't move. Unfortunately for him, he saw that the other engines were staring at him again, but now they looked rather cross, especially Hannah. He was really shaken up, you know, when you two stopped talking. Aye. And now we learn that you've been lying to him for all of this time as well. I had to lie! To everyone! If anybody had known that I was built in Scotland...
And what exactly is wrong with being built in Scotland, eh?
Nothing, nothing, but you lot don't understand what it was like on the southern region. Then why don't you enlighten us then, instead of being such a pompous, arrogant prick? Ugh. When I arrived on the southern, shortly after I was built, I was harassed daily by the local engine when they discovered where I was from. I was ridiculed. I was shunned. I was bullied no end. Once I got my smoke deflectors, they hid my building plates. And then I moved sheds, and those engines were withdrawn. So I lied. I told everyone I was an Eatley machine, and everyone believed me. I fell into the ways of the other engines. Prejudice, supremely protective of the region, and I forgot myself. Never really thought about it until now.
Oh, so you think that's all right then? You think it's fine to come to a railway and offend everybody? You know what you are, Delatrip? You're a fucking hypocrite! Now, if you'll excuse me, I'm going to go and find 257 and make sure he's alright. Because that's what real friends do.
Why hide your Scottish heritage? It should be something to be proud of, shouldn't it? Even if you were built in Scotland, you've been on the southern region all your life. If I recall, you had a wee bit of an argument with the other engines, accusing them of not being appropriate for the region. Based on what I've learnt tonight, they're probably more appropriate for this region than you are. They certainly have a better work ethic than you do. Now, if you'll excuse me.
Delatrip said nothing as Clyde rolled away, followed by Mr. B, who said nothing more. Five was the last to leave Delatrip on his own. He called over to the N15 as he puffed out of the sheds.
If you had teeth and I had feet, I'd kick your fucking teeth in, you prick! Fucking N15, think he could come here.
Delatrip watched as Five disappeared into the night, feeling like a very stupid engine indeed.